there's just no bypassing the New Orleans Superdome. For Marv Levy's luckless Chicago Blitz. Led by quarterback Vince Evans, the Blitz has proven you can be winless and still be a darn good football team. Their next test is the undefeated Breakers and the league's second-best defense, led by Marcus Merrick, an all-league inside linebacker from Ohio State, who takes us into the heat and heart of the battle.
We feel that linebackers, a group, outside linebackers and inside linebackers, we feel that we are maybe a little bit like the quarterbacks on offense. We try to, you know, keep things under control out there.
The life of a linebacker. 43,000 New Orleans fans get to watch his every move, but none of them ever hears the real story.
You ready, D, baby? Our turn coming up. Tight end. You jump the eight. Check black. Check black.
Cal, I'll tell you what I'm doing. When I'm 8-7, I'm going to go strong. This way, if I cover down tight end, you play in that middle, all right?
Oh, quick out! Quick out! Quick out! Quick out! Right away!
A bit more solemn for Marcus Dupree, New Orleans' 19-year-old rookie sensation. The other Marcus starts out strong, scoring his fourth touchdown in his three-game pro career to give the Breakers a 7-0 first-quarter lead. But a hamstring injury forces Dupree to the sideline and turns the spotlight on fellow rookie Buford Jordan, one of the best-kept secrets in the USFL. At McNeese State, the Breakers' number one draft pick ran for more yards than anyone in Louisiana collegiate history. Against Chicago, he displays yet another skill. Jordan catches 7 passes for 71 yards and a touchdown against the Blitz. He also runs for a season-high 135 yards and scores still another touchdown. Builds an early lead thanks to Jordan, and no one appreciates it more than Dupree. But the dance has just begun. Are down in the final minutes, but Johnny Walton has an able accomplice in the man who blocked for Mike Rozier in Nebraska. Mark Shellen shows him what he learned.
Don't worry about it. Hey, don't worry about it.
With Jordan back resuming his personal blitzkrieg, the Breakers seem intent on handing Chicago loss number 5. Less than 2 minutes remain when lightning strikes in the dome. Charlie Smith reaps the rewards and the Breakers seem destined to emerge on top for their 5th straight win. But Chicago comes back for more.
Gotta take some pride somewhere, fellas.
Yes, sir.
The weight, the cheese on the storm.
I read him a pool with a soft way. I saw to run down the line. I hear you say.
Huh?
Oh, I gave you an edge left call in the beginning. My fault. You didn't hear. I got to get it out of
it. A touchdown will win it. A field goal will tie. But Chicago nearly gives away its hopes for any points at all. Seibel's 23-yard field goal with no time left in regulation splits the combined 70 points evenly and sends one spectacular game into the hereafter. Receiver coach Steve Corey calls the blitz watch off early, picking the play to end all plays, not to mention the game. Phenomenal 41-35 victory has New Orleans fans rocking the dome and turns even the harshest of skeptics into believers.
Coach Corey has us believing that we are a family. It's fun to play. That's the whole thing. And I think that's why we're successful. When Coach Corey says you can take it to heart and you can feel good about it, and he's just the type of guy. I'm getting the chills now just talking about it. You know, we're happy playing together and having fun.